Hi folks, welcome back to F122 with the My Team Korea. Let's not talk about last round. However, at the end of the episode, I went into my graphic settings and I found out that the graphic settings had all reset, which would explain why I was getting massive lag in Monaco, which could have resulted in why I was going much slower than everyone else, because I was braking at the wrong moments. But I guess we'll never know. Anyway, welcome back. We are on round 8. We are heading to the Baku City Circuit in Azerbaijan. Enjoy.
qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again of our top three. David Coulthard, Smith and Charles Leclerc. And a warm welcome to you from Azadlik Square, heart of Baku, and home, of course, to the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. With high speeds, tight corners, and few runoff zones, many are expecting a safety car here today. So our drivers will have to stay very much on their toes, and hopefully out of the barriers. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit in the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience, and precision. 90-degree corners through Sector 1 lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4 mile chase flat out through Sector 3 towards the finish line. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. An immense lap from David Coulthard yesterday puts him on pole position, and Smith completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Leclerc, Fernando Alonso, and Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Sainz, Norris, Verstappen, Russell, and Sergio Perez, Ocon, Magnussen, Mick Schumacher, and Joe, Oscar Piastri, Gasly, Alex Albon, and Sebastian Vettel, Schwartzman, Tsunoda, Stroll, and Nicholas Latifi. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. With the Grand Prix nearly upon us, Anthony Davidson is by my side once again to offer his perspective. Why don't we kick off by discussing David Coulthard? That was a great win in the last race, but can they keep that momentum going into this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs. So it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. bad start, but don't overreact. We can salvage this. Second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 2.9 seconds. lap, push hard on the in lap. Seems to have been a bit of a problem removing the left front wheel. We need to try and put that behind us though and finish the race strong. Up to speed now, let's get some heat into those tyres. Remaining. cards in first place. Nice overtake. Okay, good job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
Well, that might not have been the finest race in history, but there's no question it was a critical win. And talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Well, what a thrilling end to an incredible Grand Prix weekend. Our top three finishers should be incredibly happy with what they were able to achieve out there today. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. Smith increases their championship lead. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I have to give it to Smith. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Well, that was certainly an exciting weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for more exciting Formula One action very soon.
Yeah, you can tell I switched back over.
Significantly less than the income we're pulling in. I suggest we start looking for opportunities to spend that profit margin.
Yeah, you can tell I switched back to the controller with the wheel. I was just struggling. So is that spec 2 now? Yeah, it's okay. So we can get you. There's a lot of stuff in here I haven't got. Supplies arrived. Cool. So I think there's one left for that. That's already done. So with chassis and power, aero are pretty much out. So it's really just the powertrain. And obviously the durability, but that's going to increase a bit now. Do that, get the... I'm going to keep improving him. I want him to be a really good driver. What's he sitting at? 6 mil. Alright, so he's went up, which is good. I won't only go up. So we've got 28 days. Hold on. I don't know if we can afford. I can put quality control in, maybe. I'm going to stop that just for now. Right, reinforced hydraulics, they are through.
Our new parts are completed without issue. They'll be on the car, ready for the next race weekend.
So is that for that one? Okay. So they're all done. That requires spec 3. That's all going to take 29 days, so a month's time. That's fine though. So it's good Coulthard's coming up. He'll get second, I'm sure. Unless he keeps winning and they end up beating me, I don't care. As long as someone wins from the team. But that was a much better result from us today. I'll just stick with the controller. I don't know why I thought I could use the wheel. The sensitivity is all over the place. First you brake perfectly fine, then you're braking too late, then... You could say it's to do with the way the game handles simulation, but it's not. I'm just... The wheel's all over the place. But anyway, when we come back, we will be heading to Canada for the Canadian Grand Prix. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will catch you all next time. Take care. Thank you all very much for watching. Goodbye for now.